Ah, I dropped it.
Yeah.
Okay, here's what we're talking about today. This will be an album review that I don't know if anybody... That's not even necessary. I don't know if anybody's even interested. Here's a record that I don't think really even did much. It is from 84. But again, this is what I've been listening to because I have so many albums and I just, you know, I'm so behind in listening to them that as I listen to them, I decided to start leaving my thoughts on them. So this is Bad Attitude by Meat Loaf. 1984. Meat Loaf makes great records. Well, he doesn't make all great records. Meat Loaf has made some great records. My favorite Meat Loaf album actually is Bad Out of Hell 3, which is really, really good, really solid. It's really good. And I don't know how many people bought it, but it was really good. We're not talking about this, that we're talking about this. This is Bad Attitude from 84. This is not great. I don't know. I mean, I guess Meat Loaf would be trying to find himself in the 80s because his stuff really, really kind of is soaked with the 70s, just the sound and everything about the big Meat Loaf songs in my world. So like, it starts off, it's just got synthesizers in it and really synth drums, and it's of its time. That's what he should have done. I get it, but it kind of falls flat. Meat Loaf is, to me, is a little more organic, a little more just, the guy can really sing and there's nobody like him. So I guess finding material for him is probably difficult also because Jim Steinman was not on board on this one. They only did two Jim Steinman songs on here, Nowhere Fast and Surf's Up. The rest were written by people, I don't even remember their names. Sorry, I don't know who they are. Two songs are written by John Parr. Anybody know who John Parr is? Naughty Naughty. John Parr did the St. Elmo's Fire song. I'm with us, he was high. That's not going to help. Your man in motion. I'll be your man in motion underneath this pair of wheels. That didn't help. He co-wrote that with David Foster, who produced it, which now I'm way off on a tangent. Anyway, this was not... Oops. Sorry. Light drives me crazy. There wasn't really much on here that was good. Bad Attitude was a duet with Roger Daltrey, which I just thought was a waste of Roger Daltrey. Like, if you got Roger Daltrey on board, you can do better than that song. That's not a great... It's not a bad song, but it ain't a great song. So I skipped that. Modern Girl was pretty good. It had the girl on me, but it's pretty good. Got the big Meat Loaf sound. Nowhere Fast, that's a Steinman song. That's a Meat Loaf, Jim Steinman song. That's to me, the only record song on this record that sounds like Meat Loaf. Because it sounds like Meat Loaf. Surf's Up, I thought was terrible. I kept hearing Cool Change. If you know that song, you'll know what I'm talking about. A Piece of the Action, didn't like it. Jumpin' the Gun has the cheesiest 80s goofy boo, boo, bang songs, sound effects through the song. We're jumping the gun, pew, like it keeps doing it. It doesn't do it a lot, but it's so goofy. It's really not. It's so goofy. And then Sailor to a Siren is actually a good song. I really like it. It's kind of dark and it's powerful. And that song I like. The other ones I didn't like. I hate to say it. Sorry, John Parr. I didn't like the other two songs. So out of this, Modern Girl, Nowhere Fast, and Sailor to a Siren. See, I'm doing a service to you. I'm going back to all these records that are made at a time whenever you could have half of it be good, half of it be disposable, knowingly disposable. And I'm going through there and I'm telling you what the good songs are. You don't even have to listen to the rest. Those three songs. Nowhere Fast, I Don't Want to Look, Siren to a Sailor, and Modern Girl. I got it. Those are the three. Those are pretty good. Other than that, I got nothing else to say other than Meat Loaf, Bad Out of Hell 3. That is a good one. Seriously, my rocker friends, Nikki Sixx was on that. John Five was on it. Desmond Child produced it. It's a monster. It's called The Monster's Loose. I didn't do that on purpose, but it is really good. Get those three songs and call it a day. Those are my thoughts on Bad Attitude by Meat Loaf. Thank you for listening. Subscribe to the channel. I'll talk about more random records and whatever else you want me to. I really don't care. Thank you very much for listening. All right, take care.